Hello everyone, you are watching Daily Prelims Current Affairs program brought to you by Neo IAS. Today is 9th of July 2018 and the topics we will be dealing today are World Sanskrit Conference, Teesta River, United Nations Conference on Trade and Development, Progeria, and finally we have Securities Appellate Tribunal. The 17th World Sanskrit Conference is going on in Vancouver, Canada. So the World Sanskrit Conference is organized by International Association for Sanskrit Studies. Normally it is held once in every 3 years. So the first World Sanskrit Conference was held in New Delhi, which is in the year 1972. So far three Sanskrit conferences has been held in India. So by this 2018 World Sanskrit Conference, it will be the 17th such conference. So in this conference, our delegates from over 40 countries will participate, and it will act as a platform to carry out discussion regarding the Sanskrit language and its literature. The next topic is Teesta River. Teesta River is a tributary of Brahmaputra. It originates from Pahunri Glacier, which is located in Sikkim. From there, it flows to West Bengal, then it enters Bangladesh to join Brahmaputra River. Then they together flows into Bay of Bengal. So what we should remember here is that the locations through which the river flows. It flows to Sikkim, West Bengal, then it flows to Bangladesh to flow into Bay of Bengal. So over 80% of the Teesta River, catchment area of the Teesta River is in India and the rest is in Bangladesh. The Teesta River water dispute is between Bangladesh and India, and it is there for over 3 or 4 decades. The dispute is regarding the sharing of water from the Teesta River. The Teesta River is a major lifeline for both India and Bangladesh. So speaking about some history regarding this river water dispute, in 1972, they constituted a joint river commission in order to share the water from Teesta River between India and Bangladesh. And according to it, 39% of the water goes to India and 36% goes to Bangladesh. Then another joint river commission constituted in the year 1984. It increased the quantity of water, the share of water from Teesta River to both countries. India then gets 42.5% and Bangladesh gets 37.5%. Now the dispute is that Bangladesh demands 50% water from the river during the months of December to May. Because during these 6 months, the water from Teesta River drastically decreases. This water is so much important for farmers of Bangladesh. So they are demanding 50% of the water during these months, these dry months. But India can't compromise the water from this river because it is required to meet its irrigation and agricultural needs. The next topic is the United Nations Conference on Trade and Development. The United Nations Conference on Trade and Development, as its name suggests, is a body established by United Nations. It is established as an intergovernmental body in the year 1964. The major objective of this body is to deal with trade, investment and developmental issues between the countries. Its headquarters is located in Geneva, which is in Switzerland. Its reports are submitted to United Nations General Assembly. It currently consists of over 194 member countries, and this body tries to build consensus between these countries to develop a better trade regime in the world. It normally meets once in every 4 years. So during other times, that is when the conference is not in session, there is a body called Trade and Development Board. It is the executive body of this conference. It carries out the administrative function during the time when the conference is not in session. So this body publishes several reports. UPSC has the habit of asking the reports by major organizations. So these are the reports published by United Nations Conference on Trade and Development. The reports are Trade and Development Report, Trade and Environment Review, World Investment Report, Least Developed Countries Report, Information Economy Report, a review of maritime transport, etc. Next topic is Progeria. Progeria is an autosomal dominant disease. What is autosomal? Autosomes are chromosomes other than the sex chromosomes. Human body has 46 chromosomes. 44 are autosomes and the rest 2 are sex chromosomes, XX or XY. XX for female and XY for male. Then what is this dominant? Human genes, humans or any animal genes has 2 sets of genes. And it is each one is called allele, one from each parent. So there are 2 types of allele, one is dominant and other is recessive. If there is any one of the allele is dominant, that characteristic is exhibited. And if both of the alleles are recessive, then only the recessive, then only that trait is exhibited. So this progeria is an autosomal dominant disease. That is, it is caused due to a defect in autosome, any of the 44 autosomes. And the allele causing the disease is a dominant one. So more facts regarding the disease. The disease doesn't appear till 2 years of age. After 2 years, it starts showing its symptoms. The major one is aging. Aging will be very fast. At the early stage itself, it looks very aged. The person looks very aged. It is a very rare disease and it affects only 1 in every 4 million children. It also causes complications in heart. It increases the probability of stroke. It is incurable, as it is a genetic disorder. It is incurable, but its symptoms can be treated. So other effects of this progeria are, it causes a limited growth and it results in short stature. The rate of a hair fall will be escalated. Also, it causes wrinkles in face and skin. It also stiffens the bones, the joints. The last topic is Security Appellate Tribunal. The Security Appellate Tribunal is a statutory body established under Securities and Exchange Board of India Act 1992. So the major objective behind establishment of such a body is that it is established in order to appeal against orders passed by Securities and Exchange Board of India. That is, if the SEBI passes any orders, it can be appealed to this body, that is Security Appellate Tribunal. So the Security Appellate Tribunal consists of a presiding officer and 2 other members. The Security Appellate Tribunal consists of a presiding officer and 2 other members. The presiding officer will be appointed by the central government in consultation with the Chief Justice of India. He has a tenure of 5 years or till he attains an age of 68 years. He should be either a sitting or retired judge of Supreme Court or a sitting or retired Chief Justice of High Court. So regarding the 2 members, they are appointed by the central government and they have the tenure of 5 years or till they attain the age of 62 years. The 2 members should be from the people who have proved their expertise in dealing with problems relating to securities market, or they should be experts of corporate law or economy. So while discharging its duties, the Securities Appellate Tribunal will have the power of a civil court. So that's all for today. For more news and detailed explanation, please go through our daily prelims current affairs material, which you can find it in the description box. Thanks for watching.